Hey, I hope you are doing very, 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 very well. Today, we are gonna try something new. I haven't made a painting in like 10 years, but whenever I was out west, I took a bunch of pictures and it made me want to paint again. So we are going to take this full graphite pencil. I love these for sketching. It's just the whole thing is graphite. And sketch. I don't really know how long this is gonna take. So I don't know if this, I'm definitely not gonna be able to paint a full painting in one video. Maybe this will just be sketching. Maybe we'll get into painting. I don't know, it's an adventure. But I thought I could take like a culmination of pictures. I have some close-ups and stuff too. And just see where it takes us. I was thinking about doing like a mixture of these two. Like this. Lands great with these rocks because I like all of this, and then adding a train to like the foreground, and I want to do some like bright blue and like pink graffiti on it. You can't really see the graffiti very well on this, maybe a little bit, but I also got some like close-ups of, and I was thinking about adding the engine. This is what train engines look like in America. I know they look like sleek and efficient in Europe. They don't look sleek and efficient in America. But I got some like close-ups of graffiti, like colors and kind of the line ideas that I like. Obviously not going to straight up copy those because that's someone else's art. But I am not experienced with drawing or making graffiti, so I figured just a little bit of help would be nice. So we're gonna sketch some, and then we'll see how long it is, and see if we're gonna do another one. With the actual painting, we'll have to chop down the painting because this is gonna take a while. Just gonna get a general shape first. And I've never drawn mountains before, so this will be a fun little adventure. And you know I'm gonna channel Bob Ross while we're painting. This is a cute little tumbleweed that's had a little friend in there for him, and you know. I mean, Bob Ross, like when you talk about ASMR or unintentional ASMR, he was certainly the goat, so. But I thought the different tans and light colors in these rocks were really pretty. So we can add a little happy sunshine and a little. Oh, I should have got my big fluffy wig for this. I think that probably would have been too much. A little distracting. It's gonna be hard enough to be painting, which I haven't done in forever, without also having a giant wig to contend with. I'm gonna get too in depth since I'm gonna be painting all over this. I just wanted to get some of the like rock striations and stuff in here. It's a little stair steppy. This is like a little. Oh my god, I do sound like Bob Ross. This is a little outline for me to kind of keep in mind while I put the paint down. And I mean, the graphite will mix with like white and stuff a little bit. I'm not good enough for that to even matter or show up, so I'm not worried about that either. I'm just worried about having fun and this being the first painting I've done in a while. Out West was beautiful. And it's weird because I kind of like, this is gonna sound stupid, kind of felt it in the bones a little bit, which is like normally, I don't know, normally only Maine's been able to make me feel that way, but I just felt very drawn to it. None of my ancestors are from out west. Do have Native American blood in me, but that would not make any sense since the being stuck out there for horrible reasons wouldn't make me love it. So I don't know. But we gotta fix this a little bit. Myself know there's a step and then it goes out from there. I know this is it's just a rough thing, okay? I've also been like super torn about what style I want to paint in because I never got so into painting that I established my own style. In high school I loved cubism. But that was 50 years ago, so who knows how I've changed since then. Hopefully some. I just do like cubism, but this is not going to be a cubist thing. I also thought about pointillism, you know, all the little stippling dots, which I would like because it would take forever and be meticulous, which is how I like to make art. But a horrible sound. But I don't really want that either. I think we might just kind of do impressionist. You know, since that's no one's ever done that before. You know, really stupid brush strokes and stuff. Do I want this to be smaller? Yes. Train car, a happy little train car, and then another happy little train car. Make these all the same size, Lindsay. That's one thing that is gonna be pretty standard. Okay. Another happy little train car. Let's do one more. All the little brothers and sisters together. And then let's do the engine in the front. Where's my engine? Because for this super rough drawing, I want to see this really detailed picture of an engine. And then it goes down, and then it goes up again, and then it has a little hood. There we go. Happy little engine that could. And then, can you see little? Yeah, you can see. You see little things, little wheels. It's like a dark little half wheel because there are so many tumbleweeds out there. God, I loved the tumbleweeds. They were so adorable. Just these happy little bushes. Let me see. Just happy little bushes. And then every once in a while, you would see one just go across the road, which is really unnerving because in Kentucky, if something's gonna sprint out into the road in front of you, it's going to be a deer. Really nothing else. It's like a deer or a person. And so if something is going in front of you while you're driving in Kentucky, shit's about to happen. But like, you can't like try to swerve or avoid. I mean, you can try to swerve or avoid a tumbleweed, but it would not be the right choice. You should just go through it because it's basically just like a little ball of very tiny, frail, brittle sticks. So the idea of risking a car accident to avoid it is silly. And a stupid looking train. Okay. And then we're gonna try to cover up how stupid this train looks by doing some tumbleweed shit up here. And this is just telling me to do tumbleweeds here. Because I need to be told to do that. Okay. And then in the middle, they'll get a little smaller, because that's how perspective works. I remember that from college. And then closer to the train, they'll just be little happy tumbleweeds. Just little. They're so cute. It just reminded me of these little like entities that are like, wee! And like climb, because they were climbing up the mountains, just like a community. Okay. You can't even really see that camera. There you go. Lovely. Oh my god, it looks like a lot of dicks. Okay. We'll fix that, hopefully. Or I could have a new style of painting that I wasn't planning on. Bob Ross wouldn't say that. Bob Ross would be nice. Be like, everyone can paint. The joy of painting. No one's painting, it's stupid. And then you'd see this and you'd be like, okay. Maybe a little bit stupid. And we're not doing trees, because there weren't any trees. There were some trees that just looked like big bushes, which they might call their trees. But they weren't really trees. Yeah, we'll add some texture with that paint. Okay. I'm gonna get... I ordered a paint palette, but it hasn't actually come yet. But I wanted to make this video. So I'm going to use a clear Tupperware thing that you put deviled eggs in because it has little bumps and I can seal it. And that'll actually work well because this is oil paint and it'll take a while to dry. So I'm going to go get that. I'll be right back. Okay. We got our deviled egg. So. Let's just see what happened. That was not a touch of blue. That was a lot of blue. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna do like a good base the sky first. Yeah. So I'm gonna take some white. Move over to another egg cup. And take a little bit of blue. Mix it with my brush, which you're totally not supposed to do, but. Yo po, you only paint once. I'm gonna take some more white so I can kind of feed that in. We're just gonna... It's funny because I was the most afraid of doing the sky, and now I'm doing that first. Which sky do I like the most? I should even like this guy. So we're gonna let's just put some down first, and then we'll actually go in and do more like striations. This is gonna use a lot of paint. I'm already using most of my little pile. I'm heavy-handed. I actually wanted the sky to be pretty light. So I'm just going to put these darker sections in, and then we'll go through and add a lot lighter in here with it. Seems like it's darkest over here. And it's kind of darker up here. I feel like the train looks stupid as shit, but I'm gonna have a little bit of faith in myself and say, once I actually get it painted in, it's not just rectangles, it'll look better. And you're gonna agree with me, because I can't actually hear what you're saying. And you're just a voice of encouragement over my shoulder. I guess I want you to actually see what I'm doing. So that would be good to actually show that. There we go. And you can see my creepy collection of dogs in the background. Maybe if I turn this off, that would be better. Okay. We just needed a moment. Fun thing about oil paint, sorry if you're already an expert of the different kinds of paints, but we're going to recap. The fun thing about oil paint is that it takes a long time to dry, which is also one of the shitty things about oil paint, but as you're actually painting the painting, it's a benefit because you can move it around a lot and tweak things a lot. But with acrylic, that shit dries fast and is just pretty set in its ways quickly, and you can't really go and mess with it again. I don't know if any of my painting teachers have died since I've had them, but I would think that if they have, they're probably spinning in their graves. Let's a little, actually a little gray, because it seems like there are some dark bottoms, a little stormy dark bottoms with some of these. Yeah, because you're supposed to do that on the palette, but I'm doing that on this canvas. All right, so we're going to take some of this white with some blue in it. Oh, you can almost keep doing it. And then a little bit of, oh, that was not a little bit of black. That was a lot of black. A little bit of black. And a little bit of any dark color goes a long way, but especially in white. Is that dark enough? Almost. I actually don't like to fully mix paint because I like the variations. So we have some. And then I paddle out all the variations. I'm just kind of putting down blocks of color, and then the lighter parts of the clouds will kind of tie it all in. That's what I'm saying, at least. Sounds like thunder when you're putting it on the thing. We'll let that mix in with the white because it's actually pretty gray going over there. Okay. So now we're going to get some straight up white, that'll get a little diluted. Thinking about if I'd rather you be over there. I guess it's pretty good. There we go. Happy little clown. Happy little storm cloud. So I found out whenever I was out west that I could never live in Salt Lake City. Because whenever I was driving through the salt flats, like, it had a weird reaction on my skin. Like, it got kind of bumpy and stuff, and I was like, oh my god, like, it felt like an allergic reaction. So I googled it, and apparently that is something that happens to people with really sensitive skin sometimes whenever they are in Salt Lake City. Means never Salt Lake City for me. There are probably other reasons I wouldn't want to live in Salt Lake City. But also having a permanent rash would be kind of a bummer. I'm sure there's something I could do about it, but it's much better to just use it as an excuse to never live in Salt Lake City. I'm gonna move you. Let's collapse you down. Switch sides. Good. For a second, I thought I painted on the painting that I have right there. There we go. And I almost think this is too bright for us. No, I guess it's okay. Let's see what this does. Wow, that's a horrible sound. That's almost better, right? No, let's just undo every little helpful thing we just did. I know it's like you want light while you're painting, but I feel like this is just as good. I feel like it's gonna turn out the same whether we have that light on or not. No. I'm trying to make the clouds look longer. More like, you know, they were moving across the sky and less like they were just painted in different blocks. That's starting to read a little bit better to me. We're not aiming for this to be perfect. We are aiming for it to be fun. So, and plus, once I get blocks of color down, we can just mess with it as much as we want with smaller brushes and stuff. So I'm gonna put that brush down. We're gonna go to a slightly smaller size brush for the actual mountains. Okay, so we have a bunch of yellow, a bunch of white. Some orangey brown. Actually a really close color, surprisingly. Some reddish brown. Whoa, that's really dark brown. Okay. And so I actually like putting dark colors in first. So we're gonna start with just kind of lighter, just to get a base, and then we'll kind of go back in and put the shadows in first, and then put the highlights last. Smooth on top and then craggy. And then the tip of that. So whenever I was, it's just timely, okay? Because I'm painting this scene. When I was out west, the little town that I hung out in while I was waiting for the van to be done was called Nevada City. And it couldn't have been cuter. This is one of the darkest areas. We're actually gonna use quite a big touch of black. And they had a bar, which I was walking by at like 8 o'clock in, no, not eight. It was like 9 o'clock in the morning. And I was like, oh my God, this bar is open. And the lady who worked there was just putting the sign out. And she heard me talking about it, and she was like, "Well, we make good Bloody Marys." And I was like, "Sold." So, so I went in and had a Bloody Mary. And also, apparently her specialty is called the something California Sunrise. And so, you know, I had to have one of those too, because it was when in California, drink Californian drinks. I mean, you have to, right? So it was like cranberry vodka or something, then like champagne, and then orange juice, and it was really pretty, and I drank one of those too. And then I was like, "What time do you guys open?" And she was like, "Normally 6 a.m. And I was like, I didn't say this to her, but I was like, "That can't be legal. What state? I mean, is California really like that? That you can legally open a bar at 6 a.m. And then she was like, "Oh yeah, well, so-and-so likes to run dice games in the back." And I was like, "Can I move to Nevada City and run a dice game during the week at a bar?" This just sounds better and better. I'm not going to move to California. I can't move. I used to live in San Francisco, which was cool, but like seemed totally different than I was in Northern California for this, and it seemed totally different than San Francisco did. Lindsay, either paint it fast or paint it slow. Stop going in between. Either it's an impression or it's an actual painting. Till your shit out. Fine, Lindsay. Fine. Okay, now we're gonna kind of get the majority of the excess paint off this brush. And we're gonna get into some... this color. This color. With a blob of white. I'm going to very loosely combine them. Let's place some black around here, so that whenever we get there with color, it'll blend with the black. And since it's oil paint, it'll still be dry. We're gonna do this here too. I don't even think that's technique, that's just me. We need little stair steps. I'll show directions better when we get to it. You can't do a whole painting with no black. Even I know that. So we want some right onto our train. That's good. Don't worry, we're gonna fix that edge that looks like shit. I know you were worried about it, so I guess we could go ahead and pass with it a little bit. Doesn't make any sense to have an impressionist painting and then a hard edge. It'd be fucking weird. Blocking out some white areas. I'm just showing myself directions. Okay. More. are white. Man, I used a shitload of white. When I get done with these, oh my god. When I get done with these mountains, we're gonna take a smoke break. Because let's be honest, I need it. Okay, this up here. Why? Because we're gonna need it. The hole above there. And then we'll go back in with a cleaner brush and add some like pure white to it too. And some of these have some. This is a weird strip of white right here. This is just a bunch of white. So we're gonna want some gray with that. Sorry, I'm just focused. We're just gonna dip the bottom half of the brush in white so we can get a little line. highlights and lowlights. Although this has encountered so many highlights, it's almost like it's not there. Was my back popping when I leaned back? Oh boy. Oh boy. Extreme. Excuse me. Well, I mean, it's not done. It's shaping up a little bit. You know what? I think we should take a smoke break and I should take a minute away from this and reflect on what I want to do with the mountains when we get back. My God, this is long. I'm going to have to break this up into at least two videos. This is silly. Silly long. Just carry you up there, out there. I'm gonna think. There we go. You kind of see it a different way. There we go. It's still way too blown out with the light. You're low. Let's do more. Okay. We're gonna have a smoke break and a think. A smoke break and a think, which go together. She says, oh, you're filming again. You're so boring. You're such a good girl. I think she missed me whenever I was gone for a week. She seemed happy to see me when I got back. Nicotine monster comes out. I like that though. I like if I can just like step outside of my brain and like just look at the move, like the shapes of the actual rocks and stuff, and kind of interpret that, it'll be fine. The terrain's another story. The lazy part of me is like, doesn't have to have a train. No one knows it was going to have a train. I could just paint over it with tumbleweeds. No, it's going to have a train. Maybe it should just be smaller. But... Or at least the impression of a tree. Right, Callie? I feel the same. She's just butting her head against. I cut her claws the other day on the shriveled arm that she can't put down because all of her other claws wear down like, you know, a cat's normally does. But that paw never touches the ground, so it just keeps growing, growing, growing until it's in her pad. So I just go and clip all of them. She did not like it when I was doing it, but I think she realized pretty quickly I did something to help her, because then she was happy afterwards and like really affectionate the same day. I thought when I let her go, I was like, I'm not gonna see that cat for a couple days. But there she is. Licking her asshole. Cats are great.
There's no shame, Callie.
No, she's licking her leg now, it's fine. That trip was like 4,500-ish miles. When I was in Nevada City and I shot that little like 8-minute segment thing on the street while smoking, apparently they are very anti-smoking in that area, and the only place you can smoke is in like the back patio of the bar I went to and like two other designated places in that like entire little city thing. So it's, 'cause as soon as I looked around, I saw all these non-smoking signs, and I was like, oh no. But that would have been such a me ticket to get for smoking in public. So lucky I didn't get one. I would have totally deserved it. And I was so, like, just invisible. And lucky. That would have been a fun... They said it was a $250 ticket. It would have been a fun $250 for just pure stupidity. Okay. I want to get back at it. That weird mental mode you get in whenever you're working on something. I'm sure you know what I mean. Oh my god. Oh look, it doesn't look as bad as I thought it did when I come back to it. Let's just, first things first. Let's put you down. Let's also move this light. Let's see how that works out. Easy it would be to cover up that tree. Be fun. I don't even know what color's on my brush right now. Oh, no, I don't. Okay. Let's get still stay true to the picture, Lindsay, as true as we can. Now Walter's gonna bark because he's pissed. As lovely as that would be to have in the background, let's fix that. Back. Okay. We need some dark in here. You agree? Dark lines I've decided I'm going to make the train smaller. So that's why we're cutting into it a little bit. Okay. does help when you step away and come back. Have like one distinct striation of this color. Right about there. Happy little striation. It's funny how it carries over to all of them because it was all the same level when that layer was being formed.